Hi, grade 3 and 4, welcome back. How are you today? I hope you are in good condition, stay healthy. So welcome back to our chapel this morning. So let's prepare our heart, prepare our mind to sing together, praise the Lord, and listen to God's word. So before we start our chapel, let's pray together. Fold your hand, close your eyes, let's pray. Dear Jesus, we are thank you for this morning. Thank you for the blessing that we get every single day. Now we want to begin our chapel. Please bless us so we can sing and listen to your words attentively. In your name we pray. Amen. Okay, students, so this morning we are going to sing the song. I would like to ask you to stand up. I cannot stand up because I have to play the guitar. So we are going to sing The Love of Jesus, Sweet and Marvelous. Okay, so you can do the movement by yourself. Okay, let's sing together. It's sweet and marvelous, higher than the sky, deeper than the ocean, and wider than the universe. And that's why we have to always praise the Lord every single day. Now, student, it is time for us to listen to God's word, who will be delivered by Mr. Goffin. But before we hear the words, God's words, we are going to sing the song day by day. So let's sing this song together and prepare our heart to listen to God's word. Let's sing day by day. Singing together. So now it is time for us to listen to God's word. Before we listen to God's word, let's pray. Put your hand, close your eyes, let's pray. Dear Jesus, we thank you for the time that we used to praise your name. Now the time for us to listen to your words. Please help us, Lord, to sit nicely and listen attentively, not only to listen your words but also to do your will in our life. Please bless also Mr. Govin, who will deliver your words. Thank you, Jesus. Please speak to all of us because we are ready to hear you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you. God bless you, everyone.
Hello, everyone. How are you this morning? I hope you all are good and ready to hear the word of God today. So please turn your Bible, open Mazmur 73 ayat yang ke-28. Ya, Mazmur pasal 73 ayat yang ke-28. Yang sudah dapat, please give me thumbs up. Okay. Now let me read for you. Tetapi aku suka dekat pada Allah. Aku menaruh tempat perlindunganku pada Tuhan Allah, supaya dapat menceritakan segala pekerjaannya. Nah, di sini dikatakan bahwa si pemazmur ini suka dekat pada Allah. Sekarang Mister mau tanya, anak-anak suka dekat kepada Allah atau suka dekat pada iblis? Mister harap kalian semua itu sukanya dekat pada Allah, ya. Oke, semuanya dekat sama Allah, kan? Good. Nah, sebelum kita lanjut, coba kita lihat dulu nih. Kenapa ya kira-kira si pemazmur ini, why did the psalm here, the writer of this psalm here, yeah, say like this? Ya, kenapa dia bilang, is it good for me to be near God? Kenapa dia katakan, is it good for me to be near God? Kenapa? Kenapa ya kira-kira? Kenapa katanya itu baik bagiku? Lebih baik bagiku itu untuk dekat pada Allah. So that's the story behind. Oke, okay, yuk kita buka ya. Buka di ayat yang pertama. Ayat yang pertama sampai ayat yang keempat. Oke, mari kita baca. Sesungguhnya Allah itu baik bagi mereka yang tulus hatinya, bagi mereka yang bersih hatinya. Tetapi aku, sedikit lagi maka kakiku terpeleset, nyaris aku tergelincir. Sebab aku cemburu pada pembual-pembual kalau aku melihat kemujuran orang-orang fasik. Sebab kesakitan tidak ada pada mereka, sehat dan gemuk tubuh mereka. Nah, awalnya nih, sebelum si pemazmur ini, ya, si pemazmur ini adalah Pak Asaf, ya, Asaf, Mazmur Asaf. Mazmur ini ditulis oleh Asaf. Nah, di sini dikatakan bahwa sebelum dia come to this conclusion, the conclusion in verse 28, ya, sebelum itu dia mengatakan bahwa dia itu cemburu. Yeah. There's a jealousy, there's an envy in his heart. Kenapa kira-kira? Kenapa dia bisa jealous? Ya, yeah. Kenapa? Karena dia lihat, how can this wicked man have the prosperity in their life? How can the wicked man has a happiness, have everything in their life? Kenapa orang-orang, padahal mereka orang-orang ini adalah orang-orang jahat, kok bisa sih mereka hidupnya itu sejahtera, hidupnya sehat, hidupnya enak, padahal mereka suka bohong? Why? Nah, di sini ada jealous, ya. Dia itu jealous melihat orang-orang yang padahal jahat, they are wicked, but they live in prosperity. Terus setelah itu, ya, Tuhan memperlihatkan sehingga bisa come to the conclusion pada ayat 28. Apa nih yang Tuhan kasih lihat? Ya, baca ayat 17. Sampai aku masuk ke dalam tempat kudus Allah, dan perhatikan kesudahan mereka. Sesungguhnya di tempat-tempat licin kau taruh mereka, kau jatuhkan mereka sehingga hancur. Betapa binasa mereka dalam sekejap mata, lenyap, habis oleh karena kedahsyatan. Seperti mimpi pada waktu terbangunnya Tuhan, pada waktu terjaga rupa mereka kau pandang hina. Nah, kita lihat. Mungkin pada saat itu Asaf belum sadar. He didn't realize, that there is something, after their life. Mungkin pada saat itu, Asaf lihat, kok enak banget sih hidupnya, mereka orang jahat loh. Tuhan, ini orang jahat kok bisa sih hidupnya enak? Mereka hidupnya sehat, they have everything in their life, padahal mereka itu tidak mengenal engkau. They are wicked, they like to lie. Kenapa bisa mereka hidupnya enak? Di sini Tuhan kasih lihat. God shows him that there is a judgment that will come to them. Maybe you didn't see it right now. Mungkin, maybe Asaf did not see the judgment at the time. But actually, the judgment will come to them. Apa dikatakan? Bahwa God will destroy this wicked man. Can you imagine? Meskipun, even though that maybe Asaf see that, wow, enak ya hidupnya orang jahat. Wow, there's a lot of wonder. Banyak banget keenakan yang mereka rasakan. But actually Tuhan sudah persiapkan judgment. That's why we need to be grateful. Makanya di sini Asaf itu bersyukur. Lihat di ayat 28. Tetapi aku dekat pada Allah. Aku menaruh tempat perlindunganku pada Allah supaya dapat menceritakan segala pekerjaannya. Actually, sebenarnya dengan dekat pada Allah, Asaf berada pada tempat yang tepat. He come to the Creator. Tidak seperti the wicked man. Tidak seperti orang-orang jahat. Mereka suka berbohong, membual, menceritakan kebohongan. Meskipun hidupnya enak. Meskipun hidupnya di dunia ini enak-enak saja, they have everything. Tapi nantinya apa? Akan ada judgment dari Tuhan. Dan sini we need to learn to be like Asaf. Seperti Asaf, di mana dia memilih untuk dekat pada Tuhan. Mungkin hidup di dalam Tuhan itu tidak seenak orang-orang itu yang hidup dalam yang tidak mengenal Tuhan. Untuk tidak seperti orang-orang yang tidak mengenal Tuhan, mereka hidupnya enak-enak aja sih. Tapi there's a reward. There's waiting for us. Ada reward yang Tuhan sudah siapkan. Bukan di dunia ini, but it's in heaven. Okay, so mungkin kita lihat orang-orang hidupnya enak, tapi mereka perlakuannya tidak mencerminkan kehidupan bersama Tuhan. Kita melihat mereka, dan kita sekarang adalah anak-anak Tuhan. Kita tahu mana yang benar, mana yang salah. We are grateful right now. We know Jesus. We have been saved by God. We are grateful with that. And now, what next? Ya, ketika kita sudah tahu diri kita diselamatkan, kita tahu Tuhan Yesus sudah selamatkan kita, apa yang perlu kita lakukan? Kita bisa menceritakannya. Nah, kita bisa menceritakan Tuhan Yesus kepada orang-orang. Mungkin start with your family. Ya, start with your family, baru ke orang-orang lain di luar sana. Ya, oke? Karena di dalam hidup kita, ya, even though it's not about money, maybe that God, ya, God doesn't give us a lot of money, but He, ya, remember that He will always be with us. In the midst of the trouble, yeah, in the midst of the many struggle, of course, there will always struggle that will come to our life as a Christian. Same. Di sini apa yang Tuhan Yesus katakan di dalam Lukas 9 ayat 23. Katanya kepada mereka semua, setiap orang yang mau mengikut Aku, ia harus menyangkal dirinya, memikul salibnya setiap hari dan mengikut Aku. Jadi Tuhan sih sudah kasih tahu, as His follower, we will bear the cross. Bear the cross, ya. Kalau kita bear the cross itu sulit. Tiap hari kita aktif bawa. Tapi Tuhan akan menyertai. Tuhan menyertai. Oke, Tuhan akan menyertai kita sampai pada akhirnya. Ya. Apa yang Tuhan janjikan? Ya, what if He promised to us? Ya, Tuhan menjanjikan kemuliaan. Tuhan menjanjikan tempat kita di surga. Right? That's why. Karena kebaikan Tuhan pada hidup kita, atas keselamatan Tuhan yang Tuhan telah berikan. We need to be grateful. Ya, we need to be grateful. And what next? Kita harus share it to others. Okay? So that's all for the chapel this morning. And I hope you all can get it all, and you will all can apply it in your life. Okay? So before we close, everyone, I invite you to pray now. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, thank you God for your word. Thank you for reminding us that you are God, that will never forsake us, that will always be with us. Even though we see a lot of wicked people who are living in the prosperity, but please God, you don't make us be jealous to them, but please strengthen our hearts, strengthen our mind, and make us be more faithful to you, and make us to stand firm on you, God, so that may we all also can share and proclaim about your works in our life, so that other people also can know you, and may your name will be glorified. Thank you, God. And next, we are going to continue our activity. May you bless us today. And in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Okay, everyone. That's all for our chapel. And see you again. Bye-bye.